In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to create a church flyer for conference or church conference like this in Photoshop. And this is coming up. Hey everybody, it's Innocent here and welcome to the channel. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. So here are the resources that I'll be using in this tutorial. If you want to download these images and follow suit, a link to it will be in the description. Feel free to download and let's get into the video. This time around, we're going to use Photoshop CC 2021. Yes, we upgraded. So the first thing you want to do is you want to go to create new here, and then you can create any new document that you want. You want to use inches because you want to do this for social media solely. So we are going to type in here 4x4 right over there. And then you go ahead and click on create here. So basically you should have something like this, and like I said, this is the Photoshop CC 2021, but this should work with any version that you are using. So first thing that we want to do is we want to go to the layer adjustment here, and then we want to select gradient. Now I want to head over to the gradient bar over here, and then I've already set my gradient. So if you scroll underneath of your gradient, you should see the gradients that you've already saved. But if you've not saved it, or if you are starting up, you can use the hex code here. This is the first one and this is the second one if you want to use that. Now once you're done, you just go ahead and click OK, and then OK here. So we are just going to maintain everything here, and then we go ahead and then click on OK. Now it's time to add the background. So I got this sort of communion backgrounds, and I just use that because of it is the gathering of the saints who lead us. So the first one that I'll bring in here is this background. So I'm going to drag it inside of Photoshop, and then I'm going to make sure that it is around here. So I'll go over to the blending mode here, and I'm going to set this to overlay. So I'll click on that, right click on it, and then I'm going to rasterize. I'll come down here and I'll add a layer mask to it, and I'll pick my brush tool, B for the brush tool. Make sure that my foreground color is black, and then I'll make sure that my hardness also is set to 0%, and then I'll go ahead and then I can brush off this area. Very simple, right? So the next thing that you want to add is the second background, which is this communion background. So let's drag and drop it inside of Photoshop like that, right on top of the first background that we brought. You're going to expand it like this, or you open it up, and then you're going to right click, rasterize it as well, go to the blending mode, and then you're going to set that also to overlay, and we're going to brush off this area so that it wouldn't conflict with the first background that we brought in. So we're going to add a layer mask to that one as well, and then we're going to brush off this area. Now the next things we want to do is we want to turn all of these ones into black and white. So I'll press Ctrl Shift and then U, and then I'm going to desaturate this. I'll select the first one or the next one as well, Ctrl plus Shift plus U, and then this is also going to be desaturated. Now once that is done, I'm going to make a duplicate of this communion background here, or this background, and I'm going to drag it underneath of the bottom here. So I'll place it somewhere around this area, and then I'll select my layer mask, choose my brush tool, and I'm going to brush off this area so that it blends with it. So you realize that it is the same background that we are using, only that we duplicated it and then we replaced it over here. And once that is done, we can go to the layer adjustment over here and add a bit of curves to it, as this looks very brightened. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag my curves a little bit like this so that it will be very darker. And once that is done, I can select all of these ones, press Ctrl G to group that, and I'm going to call it the background. Now the next thing that we want to do is we want to add the text and then the images whatsoever to it. So first things first, let's add the heading. So when I go to my notepad here, I've made some notes. This is not an actual event that is happening, this is just a created something. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to select the name here, that is the name of the church. I'll go for my font, and then I'm going to use Poppins, and I'll paste it right over here. So I'll select all of the fonts, change my color to white, and then I'll click OK. What I'll do next is I'll make sure that it is centered. so I can bring it in the middle over here. So this is centered, okay. And the next thing that I'll do is I'll make a duplicate and then drag it underneath here. I'm going to select all of that and type in here present. So name of your church, present. Now I can go to the toggle character here and make sure that it is not all caps. That is if you want to make use of a font with lowercase. And then I'm going to change the font here to a font called Edwardian Script. Leave links in the description if you want to use the same font. So I'm going to open that one a little bit and make sure that the tracking here is set to 0. And then I can decrease the font a little bit like that. So let me push it down here. So name of your church, present. And then the next of the things will come on. So I'm going to make another duplicate of this font, bring it down here. And then the next test that we have is gathering of the saints. So I'm going to copy that. And then I'm going to paste it right over here. Gathering of the fathers, sorry. So gathering of the fathers here. Pretty simple. And another duplicate underneath of it. And I'm going to copy conference. So I'm going to paste that also over here. So gathering of the saints conference. And for this font, I'm going to use a font called Vampire Wars. I'll leave links in the description if you want to download this font as well. So I'm going to open the size here a little bit to be very bold, because that is the center of attraction and that is going to be the conference. So we position it right over there. From there we can go back to the gathering of the fathers here, and then we can change the font color. So you double click on the color picker here and you're going to change the font color to any color that you want, preferably this one. All right, so this is going to be the test for the top. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of these ones, I'm going to group that, and then I can call it a name like top test. Okay, that is basically going to make it the test of the top. I hope it makes sense. All right, so for the next set of things that I want to do, we want to add the pictures to it. And to do that, we're going to make use of the rectangles that we have here. So you select your rectangle and then you can make a very simple, very basic rectangle like this. So something like that. We're going to make the color white over here. So we just double click on the layer thumbnail and change your color to white and click OK. Afterwards, we're going to make a duplicate. So you press Ctrl J to make a duplicate. Ctrl T to transform it, and then you're going to transform it a little bit like this. So something like that. And then for that one, you're going to change the color also so that we can see exactly where it ends. So something like this one. Okay, so once we have this, we can then start adding our images. Okay, so the first image that I want to add, I'll be making use of the pictures of these head pastors. Again, this is not an actual program that is coming on. It is just for educational purpose. So the first image is going to be Reverend Eastwood Anaba. And then I'll drag his image here. Right click, and then I'm going to create a clipping mask. So he's going to fit inside the blue rectangle that we just created. So I press Ctrl T. And then I'm going to transform him out a little bit like that. So something like this. So he has to be a bit smaller. Okay, so somewhere around here. And this looks good. Once I have that, I'm going to select all of that, group it, and then I'll make a duplicate. So I'll drag him or the duplicated one to the right side, and then I'm going to open that, delete the image like that, and then I'll go into my images. I have the next picture, which is the most reverend Dr. Paul Kwabunabo Afo. So I'm going to right click and create a clipping mask also like that. I press Ctrl T, and then I'm going to transform him out, and then to be also something like this. Cool, right? So once we have all our images in place, we can select all of these three. So select the three, go to layer, and then come to distribute here and say that distribute horizontally so that the space between them horizontally is going to be equal. Afterwards, you're going to press Ctrl G to group all of these ones, and then you can open it up a little bit because they feel so very small, and then you can make sure that they are centered and press Ctrl D to deselect it right there. And we are done with the images. So you can double click on this one and call it the images. The next set of things that we're going to add to this will be their names. So underneath of them, you're going to write their names. So that I'm going to use the font Poppins because it is very simple and everybody can see it. You can play along with different fonts, of course, but Poppins looks very cool for anyone watching the video. That is why I mostly use Poppins. Okay. Alright, so we're going to use Poppins here, and then inside the name, or inside my resource, I have the names here. So the first one is going to be Reverend Eastwood Anaba. I'll copy and paste that. I'm going to decrease the size, the font size to be very small, and the font color is going to remain white. And then I can drag the name here. Okay, so somewhere around here looks good, right? And then I'm going to hit on enter. So enter, and the next name is going to be the ministry where he's coming from. So the Eastwood Anaba ministry, and then I'm going to paste that. So I'll select all of them, go to my toggle character over here, make sure that this is around 40, and I'm going to close the leading also a little bit like this. But then I'm going to select the Eastwood Anaba Ministries, and I'm going to change the color to something more light blue, and then I'll click OK, and then OK from here. So I can press Ctrl T to transform it to be a little bit smaller, some more, because we need it to be here and here too. So the next thing that I'll do again is I'm going to make a duplicate, hold shift and drag it to the right side so that we can replace this with the name of the Most Reverend Paul Kobnabuaf. So I'll select the top here, go inside my resource, I have the name, and then I'm going to copy and paste that, and then I'll select what is underneath of it, and I'll go to my resource, and then I'll copy and paste it over here. So we do the same thing for that of Bishop Duncan Williams. So alright, so now from here you realize that some of the names are very long. So what we do is we're going to group all of these ones. So Ctrl G to group them, and then you press Ctrl T to transform it a little bit so that the names can be very small, and then it can fit to the images. So we drag this here, afterwards we drag this over here, and drag that of the very reverend's own also over here so that it will be even. So once we're done with this, we're going to group it and call it names, and that is going to be done for this one as well. So the next thing that we're going to add will be the date, the venue, and then the time. So let's quickly do that. The first thing that we're going to use is the ellipse tool, or the circle if you want to call it that way. So you hold shift and then you create a very perfect circle like this. I'm going to double click on the layer thumbnail over here to give it a color white, and I'm going to click OK over here. Let me just get rid of this one. So I'll push it to this side, and inside of that I'm going to write the date, or the day, the actual day. So it is going to be a Saturday, that is what I presumed, and for that I'm going to open it up a little bit like this, and then I'll drag it inside of my ellipse or my circle. So I'll select all of that by double clicking on the text, and I'm going to change it to the black color, or the blue black that we have over here. Let me just make this one. All right, let's try to use bold for this one. So let's go for semi bold. Okay, semi bold looks good. So we're going to make sure that it is positioned well. You press Ctrl J to make a duplicate, and then you drag it to the right side. We're going to double click on it, and we're going to change the color to white. Okay, so white over here, and click OK. So I'm going to edit this to 12 June and then 2021. All right, so I'm going to select all of these and make sure that it is left aligned, and I'll select the 12 over here. So the 12, and I'm going to open it up so that it gets to the very end of the 2021, and let's try to select the June here, change the color to something like the color that we used over here, so something quite light blue like this, and then you click OK. I'm going to close the leading a little bit like this, and then I can take my time and position it over here. So once I have that, I'll go back to my shapes and then I'm going to choose the rectangle here. I'm going to create a very small rectangle like that. And then I'll make sure that the color is white. So I'll select my color here and I'm going to change that to white. So that is going to be somewhere around here. So I'll come back to my 12 June over here, make a duplicate and drag it to the right side. Select all of it like this and I'll go inside my resource and I have this test that I've made over here. So it's going to be your time, your venue, and then the actual, the exact location. So I'm going to hit on Control plus V and it is going to paste that. So I'm going to take my time to resize this. You basically have to take your time to do that. So I'm going to select the time from this side. So select it from here. And then I'm going to change the color to the color that we use for the June 2021. And then I'll click OK. So once I have all of these ready, I'll select from the ellipse to the actual rectangle that we have here. Press Ctrl G to group it. And then I call it the date, time, and venue. And once that is grouped, I can press Ctrl A and make sure that it is centered aligned. Very simple, right? So this is basically what we have currently. The next thing that we're going to do will be the addition of the logo. And for that, I quickly use the rounded rectangle. You can use any of the shapes that you want. So I created a rounded rectangle like this. And then I actually used the Christian Council of Churches logo because they are all Christians. Okay. So I'll go inside of my resources over here and then I'll drag the logo inside of Photoshop and then I'll make sure that it is positioned in the shape that we created, so somewhere around here. And that is very quite simple. The last thing that we're going to add will be basically the effect. So for the effect, I used this particular lens flare that I downloaded from Google. So what I do is I want it underneath of the pictures or the images. So I have my images over here. So I want it underneath of this one. So I can even put it on top of the background. So I'm going to bring in my lens flare over here. So I'll drag and drop it inside of Photoshop over there like that. And then I'll position it somewhere around here. So I'll double click on it, go to the blend mode, and then I'm going to set this to screen so that mostly all the backgrounds will be gone. I right click on it and rasterize the layer from here, and then I'll go to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur, and then I'm going to blur it out a little bit so that it can look quite very nice, and then I'll click OK from here. Now you realize that the more you open it up, the more it brightens. So I'm going to open it up a little bit like that so that it brightens some more, and then I can leave it right over here. So something very simple like that. If you don't want this part, what you can do is you can add a layer mask to it and then you can just brush off these areas that you don't really want. So after I'm done with that, I'm going to make a duplicate and then I'll drag it to this side, so somewhere around here. And then you realize that I would also have to brush off this area because I don't want them to conflict. So somewhere around this area. But then for this one, I'll select the actual layer over here, press Ctrl U to activate the hue and saturation, and then I'll play around with the hue and saturation to get something good looking like this one, and then I can click OK. So I'll go to my conference. The next one is I'll right click and go to the blending options over here, and then I'm going to add a bit of shadow to it because it looks so plain. So I'll add a bit of shadow to it. And I'm going to make sure that the opacity is a little bit down, that the size is quite huge. So you drop the opacity a little bit. And then you can do the same thing to gathering of the scene. But according to this one, it looks good. So the last thing we would do is we will head over to our background. And then we have these curves over here. We're going to drag it down a little bit so that it will look way darker, something quite darker. And for the images also, you can add your own sort of effects, like you add levels, adjustments to it to look good. And yes, basically that is how you create a very simple conference flyer for your organization, your denomination. Please don't forget that this is not an actual event that is happening. it is basically for educational purpose. I'll be gaining value out of this, and if you did, subscribe to the channel would be so much appreciated. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. It's Innocent here, and bye.